welcome the class of 1963 for their 50th anniversary.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. These are the year 2013 commencement exercises of Montclair State University. I extend a warm welcome to our distinguished guests, our graduates and families and friends, and the university's faculty and staff. Please remain standing as the national anthem is sung by Michelle Sontag, who will be receiving her Bachelor of Music in Music Education today.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
Please be seated. Montclair State University. There'll be plenty of time to yell, I promise. Montclair State University was founded in 1908, and for the past 105 years, this institution has made available the possibility of a superb education to students who have demonstrated the potential for high achievement, who have shown diligence in the pursuit of their education, and who have high aspirations for using their education to the benefit of society. There were 45 students in the first graduating class. A half century ago, in 1963, there were 547 graduates, and we are joined in our celebration today by 15 of those graduates who are marking their 50th anniversary. I would like to ask the class of 1963 to please stand. At today's ceremony, we will be conferring degrees on a few more people than we did half a century ago. Today, we confer 4,320 degrees. The largest class of graduates in the university's history. All told, in its first 105 years, Montclair State has granted 128,403 degrees. The vast The vast majority of those students have been the first in their families to earn a college degree, and we have sent them out into the world just as we are today sending all of you out into the world to work hard, to pursue advanced study, and to have distinguished careers in medicine and the health professions, in science, law, business, the arts, and education. Standing on the threshold of the university's second century, we can see clearly that everything is now and always has been about possibilities. The possibilities represented by you, the possibilities of the science you will do, the businesses you will create, the children you will teach, and the music you will make, and the possibilities of the hundreds of thousands of students who will follow in your footsteps over the years to come. And this journey is now and always has been about expectations, the expectations that your families have had for you, that we have had for you, and the expectations that you will now have for yourselves. Just imagine the impact you could have on this state, on this nation, and on this world. Public higher education and institutions such as Montclair State University are the critical enablers of American democracy. There cannot be a free society, or a just society, or a prosperous society where that society does not provide for the education of its people. The role of a responsible and contributing citizen in a democracy is a difficult and complex one, and it takes preparation and it takes education. You have had the privilege of that education, a privilege denied to many in this world, to many. And you and your families and we in this university have worked hard to make that privilege possible for you. And now, you must let nothing stand between you and your future, for we will be expecting to find each and every one of you in the years to come in all those places where well-educated and dedicated people are working toward the progress of society and the well-being of people. And now, before we proceed with this ceremony, I would like to take a moment to pause and send our collective best wishes to your fellow students who have been called away from their studies this year to serve overseas in the armed forces. Dominic Salvatore Marone, Wayne Peterson, William Wagner. We look forward to their safe return to Montclair State and to the time when they will have the opportunity to stand where you stand today. And today, let us remember together your fellow students whose lives were cut short this year and who will never have the chance to stand where you stand today. Please remember with me Ed Abramsky, Eric A. Andrews, Rashonda Moore, Jeffrey Ben Rosenberg. I would ask each of you to do just one extra portion of good in your lives in the memory of those lost classmates. And now it is time to celebrate. And to help us do that, a number of special guests have joined us on the platform. Please first join me in welcoming our distinguished honorary degree recipient, S. Apatha Murkison. I would ask the members of our Board of Trustees to rise and remain standing as I call their names. Rose Calley, Francis Cuss, George Hiltzik, Ralph LaRosa, Preston Pinkett. Our student trustees, Alexei Bushkov and Kyle Bunting, and Professor Jack Baldwin LeClaire, the faculty represented to the board. You may be seated. Joining us today to celebrate your achievements are State Assemblywoman Betty Lou DeCroach and the Mayor of Montclair, Robert Jackson. Seated on the platform are your student government representatives, President George Jusden, Vice President Anthony Pizzuta, Treasurer Mark Ruff Jr., and Secretary Vanessa Deverix. I would ask the members of the university's foundation board to please stand and remain standing as I call your names. Keith Ansbacher, Greg Collins, Sandra Collins, and Nader Tavakoli. And lastly, I wish to recognize Jacqueline Alvarez. Jacqueline is a Residence Life housekeeping supervisor, and she is here today representing the staff of Montclair State who serve our students all year round, from athletic to academic advising to grounds and physical plant, from the bursar to the registrar. And I would also like to acknowledge the many staff who have volunteered today as ushers, marshals, greeters, and coordinators. MSU staff, wherever you are throughout the arena, please stand and be recognized. I now invite Ralph LaRosa, President and Chief Operating Officer of PSE&G and the Chair of our Board of Trustees, to bring greetings from the University's Board of Trustees and to present our honorary degree recipient.
Susan always has to remind me that we're responsible for keeping the lights on for the next hour or so here, so I hope we do the best. For 105 years, Montclair State has played a significant role in creating accomplished and distinguished professionals in a wide range of fields. We all look forward to seeing what all of you do with the education you have pursued and the degree you have earned. Go out there and be great. Be grateful to your family and friends and the many people at the institution who have helped you on your journey. We are extremely honored to have an extraordinary individual with us today who will receive an honorary degree from the university. Would President Cole join me at the lectern? Would Provost Gingrich and Grand Marshal please escort S. Apatha Merkerson to the lectern?
S. Apatha Merkerson earned a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree from Wayne State University and pursued a successful career as an actress on both stage and screen. As the longest serving cast member of Law and Order, the longest running crime series, you have made more screen appearances than any other primetime television actress, and through the role of Lieutenant Anita Van Buren, you have informed a broad public audience about important issues relating to the society, issues about justice, race, gender, and health. You won critical acclaim for your roles in film and theater, earning numerous honors, including 2 Obie Awards, 2 NAACP Image Awards, a Helen Hayes Award, an Emmy Award, a Golden Globe Award, a Screen Actors Guild Award, and 2 Tony Award nominations. You have also contributed to the community, dedicating time to lung cancer prevention by working with children to spread awareness about the dangers of smoking through the Campaign for Tobacco-Free Kids, and participating with the Justice Works community, an advocacy group for women convicts and ex-convicts. In recognition of your contributions, Montclair State University proudly bestows upon you Esapatha Murkison, the degree of Doctor of Letters honoris causa. Mr. LaRosa, as president of Montclair State University, and on behalf of the faculty, I am proud to present Esapatha Murkison for the degree of Doctor of Letters honoris causa.
Thank you, President Cole. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and upon the recommendation of the President and faculty, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Letters honoris causa with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which this diploma is the written witness. Congratulations.
Wow, this is this is overwhelming. To President Cole, the Board of Trustees, distinguished guests, faculty, staff, the family and friends of the 2013 graduating class of Montclair State University. I am so honored to be here this morning to celebrate with you this day of accomplishment and pure joy. I have to admit, somewhere in my suitcase is a speech that I wrote. And so I'm going to do like most actors do in this situation, back there. I'm going to speak extemporaneously, but from my heart, because I want you to know if I get teary, it's because I'm in deep menopause. But there is an analogy I'd like to make, because I don't come to you from academia, from the world of politics. I am an actor, and I do understand the importance of art and theater and music. But today I wanted to say something to you that I would hope would resonate for when you leave here. And my 86-year-old mother is here, and I would love for you to say hello. Stand, Mom. She's sitting next to my dearest friend in the whole world, Raquel Metcalf, bruh. And to my new dearest friend, Ed Feeney. But last year in June, and I'll be quick, last year in June, my then 85-year-old mother went skydiving. Okay, so we can hear the plane, but we can't see it, but we can hear it, and you're standing on the ground, and you know that at some moment, your 85-year-old mother is going to be spiraling down to the earth in a parachute. And so it was. She appears as this little pin light. And then she gets larger and larger and larger as she descends. And the look on her face, I want you to know, was pure grace. Here is a woman who raised 5 children alone. All college graduates. At a time where people said it was impossible, and she's jumped out of a plane, and she lands on the ground, and then I say to myself, are you gonna let your mother jump out of a plane and you not jump? I jumped. I'm up in the air with this crazy Australian, gung-ho Australian, and I think he might have had a little something that had to do with grass. And I'm in this plane, and we fall out of the plane, and I say to myself, keep your eyes open, keep your eyes open, keep your eyes open. Don't miss a thing, because if this is going to be your last trip, you want to see everything. But mostly because I also knew I'd never be in this situation again. Keep your eyes open, keep your eyes open, keep your eyes open. And that's my message to you today. You are at a moment of endless possibilities in your life. As I stand here, I want to drink in your enthusiasm. I'm 60 years old. So the difference from where you are to where I am to my mother, who's planning to jump at 90, is keeping your eyes open, seeing everything around you, drinking it all in, not missing a moment. This is the time where you want to start paying attention and jump out of that plane and walk your life in such grace. And that's what I wish for you, that you end up walking through this life, smelling the smells, looking at other cultures, talking to people next to you, making yourself available, listening when someone's offering, and take it all with the way what I saw in my mother's face. I wish you a life filled with grace. Congratulations.
One more round of applause. That was fantastic. Yes. I call now on Professor William McCreth, our Grand Marshal. Professor McCreth teaches in the Department of Art and Design and has served the university for 46 years. This is Professor McCreth's last commencement as he is retiring in June. You finally made it to graduation. We thank him for his many, many years of excellent service to the university.
Thank you, President Cole. It's an honor to be chosen as Grand Marshal for this auspicious occasion. But it's an even greater honor for me to present to our audience of parents, friends, graduates, the faculty of Montclair State University. Will the faculty please rise? Among these dedicated faculty is Professor Lenore Mollet of the Department of Justice Studies, who received the Distinguished Teacher Award, and Professor Iowa Lee of the Department of Mathematics, who received the Distinguished Scholar Award. Everybody is seated, so I'm supposed to say, please sit, but that's good. Thank you.
Today, greetings from the graduate students will be presented by Mom Connie Jope, who was selected by a committee of graduate faculty and students. Mom will receive her Master of Arts in Family and Child Studies today and will be entering the university's PhD program in family studies in September.
Good morning, President Call, distinguished guests, fellow graduates, families, and faculty. It is a pleasure and an honor for me to be here today to celebrate the commencement of Montclair State University, class of 2013. I would like to start by telling a short, sad story, but with a happy ending, hoping that all of you will be able to take any future challenge faced and turn it into a success. I am from Senegal. And I immigrated to the United States in an attempt to find a good education and a better life. However, in the name of cultural beliefs and patriarchal ideologies deeply rooted in my traditional household, I was told that school was not for me because I am a woman, and my only role should be to cook and care for my family. I was also told that no matter the effort I would put in, it would never pay off because English was not my primary language, and that I would be ridiculed in front of professors and classmates because I would never be able to understand what they were saying. I was told that if I insisted on going to school, the tuition would have to come out of my own pocket at a time when I was a stay-at-home mother whose only salary was the occasional thank you from my family members. I was scorned for my insistence to go to school and deprived of any financial means for fear that I would use it to start an educational journey that might liberate me. When I felt there was no longer a way out, I felt so far that I began to doubt my own abilities. I felt I was too old now to be in a classroom, and I began to transfer my dreams to my children in the hope that someday they would fulfill them. My time at Montclair State University showed me that this dream of mine could become a reality. Montclair State University taught me that I do not have to wait for my children to fulfill my dreams because I could achieve them myself. Montclair State University opened up its doors for me, and at every step of my academic journey, I was taught and mentored by kind and generous professors who guided me towards success and assured me that I could achieve my educational goals. Even today, while I'm closing this chapter of my life by graduating with a master's degree in family and child studies, a new chapter awaits me, as I was recently invited by the Family and Child Studies faculty to pursue my PhD in Family Studies. Words cannot express how empowering that was for someone who was told school was not meant for her. Graduates, I will always be grateful for being given the chance of a lifetime. Graduates, life can be unjust sometimes. You may face adversity as you prepare to enter a new phase of your life. But always remember that if a woman from a remote country of Africa can overcome hardship and a language barrier to succeed, then any one of you can accomplish your dreams. Yeah. All it takes is to keep hope alive. Be strong, stay focused, and persevere, as the journey may not be easy, but it will be up to us to make a difference in the world. Graduates, congratulations on all that you have achieved, and thank you.
Raquel Foster will receive a Bachelor of Arts degree in broadcasting today, and the news of the week is she has just been offered and accepted a position as a news assistant with Fox 5 in New York. Raquel will bring us greetings from the senior class.
President Cole, administration, faculty, staff, honored guests, parents, friends, and the members of the Montclair State University class of 2013. Who'd have thought that I'd be standing here before you giving the commencement address? I'm proof that no matter how long it may take or what obstacles you may face, you can accomplish any dreams you set for yourself. For several years, I've written in my journal, I will have my college degree, and I will give a speech on the day of my graduation. I stand here before you as a student who walked away from a full-time job because my dream was more important. I stand here before you as someone who immigrated to this country, sailing on the dreams of my mother for a better life for my brother and me, and who, despite the bumps and the hurdles in the road, have accomplished my dream of getting my college degree. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve. Napoleon Hill stated this in one of his famous works, Think and Grow Rich. Hill emphasizes that everything you see around you first began with a thought. We did not make it to commencement day by accident. Where do we see ourselves 5 years from now? In 10 years, do we want to own our own company? Do we want to be doctors? Will one of us be the next Mark Zuckerberg? Those thoughts, they become our dreams, and those dreams have the power to transform our lives. Today, we are living a perfect example of what a dream looks like. Dreams have been written about, from Martin Luther King's famous speech, I Have a Dream, to President Barack Obama's book, Dreams of My Father. That's because dreams are the things that drive our passion. They are what our desires are made of. They are the seeds for our success. We have accomplished one part of our dream by getting our college degree from the great Montclair State University. But now what? Now what? You dream some more. If in the future you begin to feel as if you've lost your excitement for your life, think back on this day. Think back on my words. And pull out your journal and dream. I will end with another famous quote from Napoleon Hill. You are the master of your destiny. You can influence, direct, and control your own environment. You can make your life what you want it to be. Congratulations, my fellow graduates of the class of 2013. May your dreams always be with you, because dreams do come true.
I now call upon Provost Willard Gingrich to present the candidates for conferment of degrees.
President Cole, it is my privilege to report to you that the candidates here assembled who have successfully completed the curricula offered by the several colleges and schools of Montclair State University have been so certified by the registrar. They are recommended by the faculty to be awarded degrees in recognition of their academic accomplishments. You will notice that a number of our undergraduate students are wearing gold tassels on their mortarboards. This signifies that these students are graduating cum laude with honors, magna cum laude with high honors, and summa cum laude with highest honors. Will those undergraduates who are graduating with honors please rise? Your family, friends, and fellow students, join me in applauding your success. Please be seated. I'm now pleased to introduce Joan Fickey, Dean of the Graduate School, to present the university's doctoral graduates.
Thank you, Provost Gingrich. It gives me great pleasure to present the university's doctoral candidates. As I call your doctoral name, will the candidates proceed to the front of the stage to be hooded by their faculty advisor and their dean. The candidates for Doctor of Audiology. Will Dean Marietta Morrissey join the candidates as I call their names? Caitlin Marie Chauvet, Faculty Advisor, Professor Ilse Wambach. Tegan Rose Fletcher, hooded today by Professor Janet Kinkey. Now we have it. Molly Folger, Faculty Advisor, Professor Ilse Wambach. Michelle Teresa Neidelman, Faculty Advisor, Professor Ilse Wambach. The candidates for the Doctor of Science in Audiology. Samuel Fox, Faculty Advisor, Professor Janet Kinkey. Alexander Emmanuel Milarevich, Faculty Advisor, Professor Ilse Wambach. The candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy in Counselor Education. Will Dean Francine Peterman join the candidates as I call their names? Daniel Sinati, Faculty Advisor, Professor Larry Berlew.
Vincent S. Viglione, Faculty Advisor, Professor Catherine Rowland. The candidates for the Doctor of Education in Pedagogy and Philosophy. Natalie Z. Chesky, hooded today by Professor Rebecca Goldstein. Nicola Eleanor Crisp, hooded today by Professor Ana Maria Villegas. Mark Bennett Hyman, Faculty Advisor, Professor Catherine Herr. Irina Victor Koroleva, hooded today by Professor Tyson Lewis. Edward Charles Ruggieri, Faculty Advisor, Professor Jaime Grinberg. Moore Yershansky, Faculty Advisor, Professor Jaime Grinberg. The candidate for the Doctor of Philosophy in Environmental Management, will Dean Robert Prezant join the candidate as I call her name? Siobhan Jean Letoa, hooded today by Professor Matthew Goring. President Cole, upon the recommendation of the faculty, I have the high honor to present these candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Audiology, Doctor of Science, Doctor of Philosophy, and Doctor of Education.
Thank you, Dean Ficke. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated doctoral degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations, doctors. You may be seated.
President Cole, it now gives me great pleasure to state that the 4,298 members of the graduating class of 2013 who have successfully completed the university's requirements for master's and bachelor's degrees stand ready to be presented to you by their deans. After the candidates from a college or school have been presented, they will remain standing until their degrees have been conferred. College of the Arts, I am pleased to introduce Dean Daniel Gerskis, who will present the 661 candidates from the College of the Arts.
Will the candidates for the master's degree in the College of the Arts please rise as I call the name of your department? Art and Design. Communication and Media. These are masters. Master's degrees, masters. You know, leave it to someone in the College of the Arts to go right to the head of the line. And there wasn't even free food involved in that. Will the candidates for the master's degree in the College of the Arts please rise as I call the name of your department? Art and Design, Communication and Media, Music, Theater and Dance. Will the families of the master's candidates from the College of the Arts please rise with your graduates? President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degree of Master of the Arts and Master of Fine Arts in the College of the Arts.
Thank you, Dean Gerskes. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated master's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations. Please be seated.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree in the College of the Arts please rise as I call the name of your department? Art and Design, Communication and Media, Music, Theater and Dance. Will the families of the bachelor's candidates from the College of the Arts please rise with your graduates? President Cole, I'm pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degrees of Bachelor of the Arts, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Music in the College of the Arts.
Thank you. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated bachelor's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations. Please be seated.
College of Education and Human Services. I am pleased to introduce Dean Francine Peterman, who will present the 1,194 candidates from the College of Education and Human Services.
Will the candidates for the master's degree in the College of Education and Human Services please rise as I call the name of your department? Counseling and Educational Leadership. Curriculum and Teaching. Educational Foundations. Early Childhood, Elementary, and Literacy Education. Exercise Science and Physical Education. Health and Nutrition Sciences. Will the families of the master's candidates from the College of Education and Human Services please rise with your graduates and loved ones? President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degrees of Master of Arts, Master of Arts in Teaching, and Master of Education in the College of Education and Human Services.
Thank you, Dean Peterman. By virtue of the authority vested in me in the state by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated master's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations, masters. Please be seated.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree in the College of Education and Human Services please rise as I call the name of your department? Exercise Science and Physical Education. Family and Child Studies. Health and Nutrition Sciences. Will the families of the bachelor's candidates from the College of Education and Human Services please rise with your graduates and loved ones? President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degrees of Bachelor's of Science and Bachelor of Arts in the College of Education and Human Services.
Thank you, Dean Peterman. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated bachelor's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations. Please be seated.
Now, certification of teacher candidates. Dean Peterman will now testify concerning the certification of members of the class to teach.
Will the members of the class of 2013 who participated in the teacher education program, undergraduate or graduate, in any school or college, please rise? President Cole, it gives me pleasure to state that 760 members of this class who have successfully completed their academic majors, a professional sequence, and the appropriate examination are certified and qualified to teach in the public schools of the state of New Jersey.
Thank you. Will the future teachers of New Jersey please be seated?
The College of Humanities and Social Sciences. I am pleased to introduce Dean Marietta Morrissey, who will present the 1,378 candidates from the College of Humanities and Social Sciences.
Will the candidates for the master's degree in the College of Humanities and Social Sciences please rise as I call the name of your department or program? Child Advocacy. Communication Sciences and Disorders. English. History, Linguistics, Modern Languages and Literatures, Political Science and Law, Psychology, Sociology, Spanish and Italian. Will the families of the master's candidates from the College of Humanities and Social Sciences please rise with your graduates? President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degree of Master of Arts in the College of Humanities and Social Sciences.
Thank you, Dean Morrissey. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated master's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations, graduates.
Will candidates for the bachelor's degree in the College of Humanities and Social Sciences please rise as I call the name of your department or program? Anthropology, Child Advocacy, Classics and General Humanities, English, History, Justice Studies, Linguistics, Modern Languages and Literatures, Philosophy and Religion, Political Science and Law, Psychology, Sociology, Spanish and Italian, Women's and Gender Studies. Will the families of the bachelor's candidates from the College of Humanities and Social Sciences please rise with your graduates? President Cole. President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in the College of Humanities and Social Sciences.
Thank you, Dean Morrissey. So, do you want these degrees? By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you, as earned, the designated bachelor's degree with all the rights, duties, and privileges thereto pertaining. Which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations, graduates. Please be seated. Before, settle down. Before we proceed any further, I have been informed that there was a group of master's graduates that were left out, the Master's in Family and Child Studies. Is that the right one?
That's correct.
Is that correct? And Master of Education? All right, then. Those graduates now rise. And your families. And by virtue of the authority vested in me, this is going to be made good, by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievements in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated master's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations.
The College of Science and Mathematics. I am pleased to present Dean Robert Prezant, who will present the 471 candidates from the College of Science and Mathematics.
Will the candidates for the master's degree in the College of Science and Mathematics please rise as I call the name of your department or program? Biology and Molecular Biology. Chemistry and Biochemistry. Computer Science, Earth and Environmental Studies, Mathematical Sciences. Will the families of the master's candidates from the College of Science and Mathematics please rise with your graduates? President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degrees of Master of Arts and Master of Science in the College of Science and Mathematics.
Thank you, Dean Poussin. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated master's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations, masters. Please be seated.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree in the College of Science and Mathematics please rise as I call the name of your department or program? Aquatic and Coastal Sciences, Biology and Molecular Biology, Chemistry and Biochemistry, Computer Science, Earth and Environmental Studies, Mathematical Sciences. Will the families of the bachelor's candidates from the College of Science and Mathematics please rise with your graduates? President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degree of Bachelor of Science in the College of Science and Mathematics.
Thank you. All right then. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you, as earned, the designated bachelor's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations. Please be seated.
School of Business. I am pleased to introduce Dean Brent Kreit of the School of Business, who will present the 549 candidates from the School of Business.
Will the candidates for the master's degree in the School of Business please rise as I call the name of your department? Accounting, Law and Taxation, Economics and Finance, Information and Operations Management, Management, Marketing. Will the families of the master's candidates from the School of Business please rise with their graduates? President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degree of Master of Science and Master of Business Administration in the School of Business.
Thank you, Dean Kreit. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the curricula prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated master's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations, graduates. Please be seated.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree in the School of Business please rise as I call the name of your department? Accounting, Law and Taxation, Economics and Finance, Information and Operations Management, Management, Marketing. Will the families of the bachelor's candidates from the School of Business please rise
with your graduates. President Cole, I am pleased to present the candidates who have qualified for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Business.
Thank you, Dean Kreit. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Montclair State University, and in recognition of your achievement in fulfilling the criteria prescribed, I confer upon you as earned the designated bachelor's degree with all the rights, duties, privileges, and immunities thereunto appertaining, of which the diploma is the written witness. Congratulations. Will the graduates please be seated? I would now like to invite Provost Gingrich and Professor McCreth to please join me at the lectern to direct the undergraduate tassel ceremony.
Seniors, please rise. When the Grand Marshal signals with his mace, the undergraduate students will please move your tassel from the right side to the left side of your mortarboard. Ready? Go. Are you sure you're ready? Okay. President Cole, I am pleased to present to you and your guests the graduates of the class of 2013.
Seated. We're almost there. Please be seated. Thank you. Chris Fitzpatrick is a graduate of the class of 2004, and he is chair of the recent alumni network. Chris will bring greetings from the alumni.
It's official, class of 2013. Congratulations and welcome. Today, as you make the transition from students to alumni, we truly hope that you will remember your Montclair State experience with thanks, satisfaction, and fondness. As graduates of the class of 2013, you join a vital network of more than 100,000 Red Hawks with whom you share a common bond. I am proud to bring you greetings on their behalf. As you stand on the threshold of the next phase of your lives, I ask you to remember one thing. Your connection to this great university does not end today. It lasts a lifetime. The people that you've met at Montclair State and the alumni that you will meet going forward can serve as friends, mentors, and professional contacts for the many years to come. To this end, I hope you will stay connected by joining our recent alumni network. We are constantly coming up with exciting programs, from networking and social events to reunions and special homecoming activities for alumni just like you. I also urge you to take a moment to join our online community, Montclair Connect. Your fellow alumni join me in wishing you all of the very best. Enjoy your day.
Jordan Barry received her Bachelor of Music in Music Education today and will lead us in the singing of the Alma Mater, which, in case you haven't memorized it, is printed on page 6 of your program or on the back of your program card. I ask all assembled here, especially our newest alumni, the class of 2013, to stand and join us.
Beneath the Jersey sky so blue, in Montclair's mountain town, there stands a college tried and true and growing in renown. We love thy campus, love thy halls, and off to thee we raise with loyal lips and loyal heart, united songs of praise. All hail, all hail, Montclair, to thee our voices raise. Alma Mater, dear Montclair, our undying hymn of praise.
Will everyone please be seated? This concludes the 2013 Montclair State University commencement exercises. I would ask everyone please to remain seated until the recessional is complete.
Thank you. Thank you.